Hello students, as you are seeing on the screen, I have given you these four sums to be solved at home by you. These four sums are based on the property that we have studied in the last two lectures. You know the property, I will repeat. The property is the ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to the ratio of products of their bases and corresponding heights. That is A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 into H1 upon B2 into H2. I feel that these four sums you must have solved with a great ease. If you have any doubt, then you can wait because I will give the solutions of these sums in other lecture, in the consequent lecture. Now today we are studying a very important theorem, as I had mentioned in the last lecture, and that theorem is the basic proportionality theorem. Also we will study its converse and two more properties, which are nothing but the application of basic proportionality theorem. So today's lecture will be based on these four things. 1. The basic proportionality theorem, popularly called as B.P.T, its converse, and two more properties based on basic proportionality theorem. Here you can see the statement of basic proportionality theorem. Please remember the statement also, because in the exam they can ask this theorem as a sum like state and prove basic proportionality theorem. So remembering statement is very, very important. Read the statement. It says, if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle intersects other two sides in distinct points, then the two sides are divided by the line in the same ratio. Understand? This is the statement of basic proportionality theorem. Think about it. What does the statement mean? So, as per the statement you are seeing, I have drawn triangle ABC and a line XY which is parallel to side BC of triangle ABC. This line XY is such that it intersects side AB at point X and side AC at point Y. So I have drawn the figure as per the statement. And you have studied in 900 that in the statement, which is of if then type statement, conditional statement, the part of the statement that follows if, that is a line drawn parallel to one side of triangle intersects other two sides in distinct points. Till here this is called as antecedent. Antecedent stands for given. So I have written in triangle ABC, line XY is parallel to side BC such that point X and Y lie on sides AB and AC. You are seeing here A dash, X dash, B, the betweenness, A dash, Y dash, C, betweenness. So this is what, like, you know, given, antecedent. Now we have to see about the consequent. Consequent is the part of the statement which follows then. What is the consequent? The two sides are divided by the line in the same ratio. That means I have to prove that AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. Why? Because line XY divides side AB and AC of the triangle ABC in the same ratio. That means AX upon XB, ratio of these two parts, is equal to ratio of AY to YC. These two ratios are equal. That is what we have to prove, and this is what the basic proportionality theorem is to prove, is the consequent. The two sides are divided by the line in the same ratio. Understand? So construction is needed. I have done the construction. The construction needed is draw seg XC and seg YB. You can see I have meet the construction by dotted line segment XE and segment YB. Now we shall go for the proof. How to prove this? Remember, for the proof we will need the property which we have already proved earlier, and that property is the property of areas of two triangles. Okay, we will use the property. How we will use? Let's see. We will write the proof now. Students, you are seeing the triangle AXY and triangle XYB have same height from vertex Y. What I have written? Triangle AXY and triangle XYB have same height from vertex Y. You can see I have drawn for your understanding with red dotted line the height of triangle AXY, which is an acute angle triangle, and triangle XYB, which is an obtuse angle triangle. The height is drawn on the extended base. Now when the two triangles have same height, then the areas of the two triangles are equal to the ratio of their, the ratio of the areas of the two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases, because height is same. What reason we will write for this? You know, triangles having same height, triangles having same height. Either we can write this reason, or we can also write, if you don't want to write this, we can write the mathematical form A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 when H1 is equal to H2. So we can write this form also of the reason, the mathematical form of the reason. Or we may write this way, as it is given in the textbook, triangles having same height. And this will be our statement number one. Remember this again, because this is very important to understand. Triangle AXY and triangle XYB have same height from vertex Y, as you are seeing here. So area of triangle AXY upon area of triangle XYB is equal to AX upon XB. Reason, triangles having same height, or A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 when H1 is equal to H2. Let's go to the next frame. So we have proved. Now similarly, please keep the figure in front of you because it is not there in this screen. As per the figure, triangle AXY and triangle XYC have same height from vertex X. Okay, the figure is to be kept in your front. Now when the two triangles have same height, then the areas are proportional to corresponding bases. So area of triangle AXY upon area of triangle XYC is equal to AY upon YC. Reason, as we have written earlier, we can write here triangles having same height, or A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 when H1 is equal to H2. This is result number 2. Also, what I have written, please mind. Triangle XYB and triangle XYC, which form the denominators of result 1 and result 2. These triangles have same base, that is segment XY, and they have same height as they lie between the same parallel lines. Okay, that figure you have to keep in front, then only you can understand this. So when two triangles have same base and same height, then we use the fourth property that we have studied in the earlier lecture, that A1 is equal to A2 when B1 is equal to B2 and H1 is equal to H2. So area triangle XYB is equal to area triangle XYC. This is result number 3. Now from 1, 2 and 3, what we are getting? The right, left hand sides are equal. Area of triangle AXY upon area of triangle XYB is equal to area of triangle AXY upon area of triangle XYC from 1, 2 and 3, and that is result number 4. Now see very carefully why these two are equal, because the numerators are equal and even denominators are equal. Denominators are equal is shown here, you can see here, and that's why these two ratios are equal. Now value of this ratio is AX upon XB, and value of this ratio is ay upon yc, that you can see here, ay upon yc, and ax upon xb is in the earlier screen. Okay, so these two ratios are equal, and that is what we have to prove. Okay, this we get from 1, 2 and 4, because this is the fourth one. Hence the theorem is proved. Again, I will show you the first screen so you can understand. So as you are seeing, in triangle ABC, line XY is parallel to side BC, such that A dash, X dash, P, A dash, Y dash, C. We have to prove that AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. What we started with? Area triangle AXY and triangle XYB have same height drawn from vertex Y. Therefore, their areas are proportional to corresponding bases. In triangle AXY, the base is AX, and in triangle XYB, the base is XB. This is the height. Result number 1. And here you are seeing triangle AXY and triangle XYC have same height from vertex X. Area triangle, therefore area triangle AXY upon area triangle XYC is equal to AY upon YC. Triangles having same height. Okay. Also, triangle XYB and triangle XYC have same base, that is seg XY, and they have same height as they lie between the same parallel lines. This I will show you in the first screen. See this, triangle XYB and triangle XYC, they have same base XY and they lie between the same parallel line. This line XY is parallel to side BC. So these triangles have same height. Both of them, you know, appear to be, they are obtuse angle triangle. Okay, so their height will be equal. The base is extended. I have not drawn the height, but you can understand. Understand? So you are seeing that triangle, area triangle XYB is equal to area triangle XYC. So from result 1, 2 and 3 we get ratio of area triangle AXY upon area triangle XYB is equal to ratio area triangle AXY upon area triangle XYC. But we know that the value of this ratio is AX upon XB and value of this ratio is AY upon YC from 1, 2 and 4. Thus the theorem is proved. This theorem is called as the basic proportionality theorem. What is the statement again? Recall in mind, if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, intersects other two sides in distinct points, then the two sides are divided by the line in the same ratio. The theorem is proved. The theorem is very, very important, and all should remember this because it is asked in the board examination. So this is the basic proportionality theorem. Now, we will go for the converse of basic proportionality theorem. Normally, the proof of the converse theorem is not asked. However, I will orally give you the idea of the proof of converse of basic proportionality theorem. But first of all, we will write the statement of the converse of basic proportionality theorem. This converse statement is there in your textbook. Please see and find out where the statement is. So here is the statement of converse of basic proportionality theorem. The statement says, if a line divides any two sides of a triangle in equal ratios, then the line is parallel to the third side of the triangle. Understand very carefully. Again, a line is dividing any two sides of triangle in the same ratios, then that line is parallel to the third side of the triangle. Understand? Try to draw a diagram and understand. So you are seeing, I have already drawn the diagram. In triangle ABC, line XY is such that it divides sides AB and AC in the same ratio. That is, what is given? In triangle ABC, AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. And point X and Y are on the sides AB and AC. Okay, that's why I have written A dash X dash B, A dash Y dash C, the betweenness. We have to prove that this line XY is parallel to the third side of the triangle. Third side, why it is third side? Because these two sides are already divided by the line. So this is the third side. We have to prove that line XY is parallel to side BC. Understand? Now think, how will you prove? So I have given you the hint. I have not given you the proof. How will you do it? First of all, we are given AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. This is given. Now use invertendo. Invertendo you have already studied in 9th standard. So it will be XB upon AX is equal to YC upon AY. Okay, invertendo. After that, you have to use componendo. So what will be the componendo? XB plus AX upon AX is equal to YC plus AY upon YC. That's why upon AY. That's why you will be getting this. AB upon AX is equal to AY AC upon AY. This you will get. Okay, because when we do componendo, we will get this. Now this will help us to prove triangle ABC and triangle AXY similar to each other by SAS test. Which triangle? Triangle ABC and triangle AXY will be similar by side angle side test, angle A being the common angle. Once the triangles will be proved similar, you can say that angle ABC is congruent to angle AXY. These two angles are congruent, or these two angles can also be equal to congruent, but they form a pair of corresponding angles, and if the corresponding angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. Therefore, line XY will be parallel to line BC, that is, line XY will be parallel to side BC. This is how the converse of basic proportionality theorem is proved. The converse is, if a line divides any two sides of triangle in the same ratios, yeah, the equal ratios, then the line is parallel to the third side of the triangle. And this is what, like, you know, the hint I have given. Try to write a systematic proof. Okay, there is no need of construction, but these are the steps I have given you so that you can write a very systematic proof. Okay, all the best for writing the proof. Now we will go to, like, solve certain sums based on these two. One is the basic proportionality theorem, another is the converse of basic proportionality theorem. So there is a sum based on basic proportionality theorem. What is given to us? In triangle ABC, XY is parallel to side BC, and AX is 4, XB is 3, AY is 6, find YC. Understand? So it is very clear that we can use basic proportionality theorem. According to the basic proportionality theorem, if the line XY is parallel to side BC and divides the two sides in distinct points, then the two sides are divided in the same ratio. Then in the solution, what you will write? In the solution, we will write in triangle ABC, line XY parallel to side BC. Line XY is parallel to side BC. This is given to us. Therefore, by basic proportionality theorem, try to write full form basic proportionality theorem. What we can write? AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. So we will write, you know, the values now. AX is how much? 4. XB is how much? 3. AY is how much? 6. And what is the value of YC? That is what we have to find. So how will you do it? Cross multiplying. 4YC, yeah, the 4 into YC is equal to 6 into 3. So what is YC equal to? YC is equal to 6 into 3 upon 4. Cancel this. 2 2s are 2 3s are. So we have YC is equal to 3 3s are 9 upon 2. So how much is YC? YC is equal to 4.5 units. So this is our value. So this is how, like, you know, the theorem, basic proportionality theorem, can be applied to solve sums. This is the application of the basic proportionality theorem. Okay, they may change the values. They may give you any three parts and they can ask you to find the fourth part. Okay, this is very simple. Modification can be applied in the sums and The basic idea is this: you have to apply basic proportionality theorem. Now we will solve one sum of converse of basic proportionality theorem. How it is applied? Let's see that. As you can see here, I have given you a question. What is it? State if line L is parallel to side BC of triangle ABC in the given figure. This is triangle ABC. Line L cuts side AB at point X and side AC at point Y, so that length of segment AX is 3 unit, XB is 4 unit, AY is 4.5 unit and YC is 6 unit. Now we have to find out whether line L is parallel to side BC or not. So how will you do it? So in the solution, first of all, what you will write? We will write that what is the ratio of part AX to part XB, which are the two parts of side AB. So AX to XB ratio will be 3 upon 4 because both the values are given. Okay, this is given and result number 1. Now we will find the ratio of these two parts, AY to YC. So AY upon YC will be equal to 4.5 upon 6. Now basically they are same, but they are not looking same. Okay, how will you do it? Remove this decimal point. It will be 45 upon, this will multiply with 10. 6 will multiply with 10. So it will be 60. Now we know that this can be cancelled in the table of 15. 15 threes are, 15 fours are. So this ratio is 3 upon 4. Okay, this is also given, which is result number 2. So from 1 and 2 what we see? Therefore, in triangle ABC, what do we see? We see that the ratio AX upon XB is equal to the ratio AY upon YC. This I get from 1 and 2. 1 and 2, what is the meaning of this? This means that in triangle ABC, line L divides side AB and side AC in the ratio, right, 3 is to 4. That is, these two ratios are equal. AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. That we have proved from 1 and 2. Therefore, we can say that line XY is parallel to side BC. The reason is converse of basic proportionality theorem. This is the application. That is, we can write that line L is parallel to side BC because line XY is nothing but line L. So line L is parallel to side BC. This is how we use the converse of basic proportionality theorem. In the board exam, the application of BPT and converse of BPT can be asked for 2 marks. There may be modifications also. They may sometimes give you the entire side, okay, and they may try to give you the same question, that whether the line L is parallel to side BC or not. Okay, similar sums can be asked. So you can refer to your exercise 1.2 for these two theorems. One is the basic proportionality theorem, another is the converse of basic proportionality theorem. The similar sums you will find out, and you will solve the sums. I had planned today to teach you 2 more properties which are nothing but the applications of BPT, but I think so today's content is sufficient for you, and remembering the 2 theorems and their applications and the sums based on them, very very important part of the chapter. Okay, more we will discuss in the next lecture. So students, here are few sums for home assignment. In the first sum, I have given you 2 problems wherein you have to find value of X. You can see triangle PQR is there. Line L is parallel to side PQ and the different measurements are given, and you have to find the value of X here. Here also you have to find the value of X here. And the second sum, you are seeing here, we have to state whether line L is parallel to side QR or not. Okay, the 2 sums I have given, one is based on BPT, other is based on converse of BPT. So use your brain and solve these sums. Even I will advise that you can solve sum number 2 and sum number 4 of your exercise 1.2 Okay, you may write down that question 2 and question 4 of exercise 1.2 you can solve. Okay, they are little bit tricky, however, like, you know, use your brain, because both these sums are based on BPT or converse of BPT. With this, we end today's lecture. In the fourth lecture, we will solve two properties based on the basic proportionality theorem. One property is called as property of angle bisector of a triangle, and the other property is called as the property of intercepts made by three parallel lines. These two properties are also very, very important applications. That is, sums based on these properties are also asked in the board examination. I hope today's lecture was good. You would have understand basic proportionality theorem and the converse of basic proportionality theorem. Today is like lecture, I have given you few homework or home assignment. This is the home assignment, and even I have left the converse of basic proportionality theorem to be proved by yourself. Okay, that will be on you. With this, wish you goodbye. Take care of your health, stay at home, and make use of the time. Goodbye. Nice day.